Hey guys, back out from a pet here. Today is day 6 of our Thanksgiving harvest. Hope you guys have been enjoying the harvest video so far. In today's video, we're getting back to those sweet potatoes. We're going to be harvesting a small side bed that I have. It's a 4x4 bed that I have Murasaki sweet potatoes. So guys, without further ado, let's get started. It's day 6 harvest videos. All right, so here is the bed. I have been pulling sweet potatoes from along the sides, so I know that there are sweet potatoes in there. As you can see, this vine is not quite as vigorous as on the other side. We did have some rain, a lot of rain, over the past maybe month. We haven't had any in the past 2 weeks, but like we had like a good month of rain. So before it was kind of a little bit dry, but at least it got the nutrients from the rain. Plus it was initially planted in good soil, so I'm hoping that we're gonna see some good potatoes in here. So I'm gonna go ahead and set the camera up. This should be a whole lot easier than the first harvest that I did. If you guys missed that harvest, I had to harvest sweet potatoes among all the different yams. I had a whole bunch of African yams planted or in the same bed as the sweet potatoes, so it was really tricky trying to get just sweet potatoes. So let's go ahead and get this cut back. All right, so just cut some along from along the edges, but I can see where some actually connected to the soil, because as pulling them out from along the side of the bed, I'm finding little potatoes. So I think we're gonna have to harvest around the edge. So here, another little one. Oh, okay. All right, here's one. Oh boy, this is no good. This is no good. Look at it. Something looked like it was eaten away at it. That's not good. So that's gonna go in the garbage. Oh, and here's another one. Oh, looks like I pulled some up when I was pulling up. So here's one good one. And here is another one that got pulled up. Alright. Oops. Hold on. Alright, so I'm seeing some pots sticking out of the ground. So let me move the camera here. Point down. Alright, so this bed is a lot smaller than the previous bed. On my harvest that I did day one, I got 25 pounds of potatoes, but that was an 8x4. This bed, I believe, is a 3x6. So far, we have this one. We have this. I see this one here. Looks a little bit chewed up. I don't know if I waited too long to harvest this bed. They're looking a bit worn. Like here, here is one rotted one. So maybe I waited too long. But let's go ahead and harvest anyway. It's just the beginning. Small ones. So sweet potatoes are heavy feeders. You should feed them throughout the growing season. And you should keep them evenly moistened. I didn't have a watering system till recently. I just got a sprinkler system. I need to check and see if this bed even gets water, because this is like pure sand. And I know I fertilized it when I planted them. Alright, so I'm gonna go through, see what I can find. Okay, so this was disappointing compared to the largest one I got from Monday's harvest. This is the largest one I got from today's harvest. I don't even think this is 2 pounds. Some of them that I found were chewed up or, you know, starting to decay. And some of these that I got were actually from behind the bed. Like the vines caught on and were from behind the bed. So I'll weigh it. I got 25 pounds on Monday from my 8x4. Some of these, I don't even know if they're edible. Some of these, you know, they look a bit rough. Look at that. I'll have to see. I don't even know if I'm going to... Yeah, I definitely won't eat this. Look at that. So, I would say this is maybe a pound, pound and a half. Not much compared to 25 pounds. Even though this is a smaller bed. So, I definitely don't think I'm gonna grow sweet potatoes in this bed again. I'm wondering if it's because of the metal. Because I know this is the second time that sweet potatoes have grown here. And this is always disappointing. The one in the wooden bed is good, and the ones that are directly in ground are very good. But this bed is the second time that I haven't got much. So I think I'm going to switch this over to maybe tomatoes or something else. It does get full sun. So I'll decide. I'll enrich the soil and then plant something else. I have planted corn in here before. Before the potatoes, I had planted corn. The corn did well. There was some corn pest, but the corn did well. So anyway, just wanted to show you guys today's harvest. That is, I would say, maybe a pound and a half. Yeah. All right. So, guys, this tells you it can't all be perfect. It cannot all be perfect. There are times that you harvest and, you know, the insects get to it before you do. Or, you know, or it's just a disappointing harvest. But that should never stop you from continuing to grow. If it doesn't work in this bed, no problem. I'm just gonna move back to the wooden bed or plant in ground next time. But I will keep on growing. So guys, the whole purpose of these videos, this Thanksgiving harvest series, is to encourage you guys to grow food. So we have, how many days? 16 days left of harvest. And I hope this encourages you to go out there. Let's plant seeds together, guys. Let's grow our own food. Let's do this, guys. We can do it. All right, till next time. Bye now. Thanking God for my harvest. No matter how small, I always thank Him. Thank you, Lord. You are the God of the harvest, and I thank you for every good and perfect gift. Bye now. Till next time.